Welcome back. So in the previous video, we saw how I'm using the widgets to tell myself what I should be focusing on now. You should already have yourself set up with the toggle account and timery. If you haven't done that already, just go back and watch the last video. Make sure you've done that. What we're going to do now is to combine these timers with Apple's focus modes to help you stay focused. So here's a diagram to explain how this all fits together. So the larger blocks on this diagram, the containing blocks, are Apple's focus modes. And within each of these focus modes, we've got timers that correspond to the type of work we're doing in that mode. And in fact, it's not the type of work. The type of work is the mode. I'm either at work, I'm having some personal time, or I'm offline. And then within there, the smaller blocks are the individual pieces of work that I'm doing. So in my work mode, in a Johnny.Decimal context, I'm using the IDs from my Johnny.Decimal system. And as we've spoken about, in personal, I'm mostly just in a uncategorized personal life mode, but I am using one of my IDs specifically to track when I do fitness, which is interesting. You might want to do that. So then through the course of the day, what we do is we switch between focus modes and or switch timers within focus modes. So I'm going to set you up two focus modes to start with, work and offline. For our personal stuff in green, I'm not going to use a focus mode. What I'm going to do is, if you're not using focus modes, you're just in this default state of not being in a focus mode, and that's what I use for my default non-focused state, my personal life. One of the ways we can help ourselves is by being consistent. It's another Johnny.Decimal theme. Consistency helps your brain. So what I do here is I color code things consistently across these different ways of being organized. So your home screen will have a color. Timery has colors attached to projects. This diagram you're looking at, it's got the same colors. So what I'm using is, I've chosen orange as work because that's kind of the Johnny.Decimal color. Green is my personal stuff, and I'm using red or like a purple for my offline, because the idea there is I'm trying to tell myself to kind of stay away from this. Now, as we've got two things to switch between, focus modes and timers, I use Apple shortcuts to do this. And the shortcut switches the focus mode and the timer in one action. This gives us some other quality of life improvements, which I'll show you through this video. So let's show this in action. I'm going to use the menu bar for shortcuts, which is one of these quality of life improvements. And if we activate Start Work, which is a shortcut, I'm shown a list of my saved timers from Timery, and I've actually filtered these on only the timers that relate to work. So this is how I choose what I'm going to work on. I go to the menu bar, I drop down Start Work, and from the list of saved work timers, I choose what I'm starting to work on. So let's start 90033, which is this project. You can see the timer starts and the focus mode is set. Now, remember the point of this, right? This is me telling myself what I'm working on. I've made a decision. I'm saying to myself, do this and not something else. And that's really important, because I can still just choose to do something else, right? My system's not going to stop me. My computer doesn't prevent me doing anything else. And that's what I want. Like I said in the first video, I'm trying to make this a habit. And I consider this a bit like personal training. Then if we activate offline mode, there is nothing to choose. My offline shortcut takes me to an offline focus mode, and I only have one offline timer, so it just does that and there's no need for me to choose. The cool thing is that once you've got this set up on your home screens, which we're going to get to, activating this mode from any device switches it on all of your devices automatically, which is really nice. Offline for me, just a note on this term, offline for me means no interaction with my business. That's the reason I chose this offline mode specifically, as opposed to just always being in personal untracked time, which again, I'll explain why I've come up with these more as we go through this series. But offline for me was, I realized at the end of the day, I'm in my home office now, right? This is the second bedroom in our house. And then I go next door and I'm in the kitchen and I've finished work. And it's so easy to just keep being at work, to keep checking my mail, to keep, you know, checking my sales figures or whatever. So for me, offline means no interaction with my business. It means I need to shut my brain down. And I'm kind of trying to have it mean no computers, but, you know, I use my computer when I'm in the kitchen. I use my recipe app to cook or I play some music. So it's not so strict for me that if I watch a bit of YouTube on the couch or send my sister a message, that's fine for my offline. So you'll decide a bit of this based on your own life and your own rules. So on this home timer, this untracked personal time thing, if I'm not at work, I don't care what I'm doing, right? If I'm going to the shops, or if me and Lucy are going for a walk, or if I'm going for a bike ride, that's not something I need to track. So for me, untracked personal time just means not at work and not in this special offline mode. I'm just living life. That's why I've chosen a chicken icon for it, because ideally I'm in the backyard with a chicken. You might want to track some specific stuff like exercise, and the only other one I've got currently is exercise, and this is cool. I'm going to show you how you can use those little cheap NFC tags. Here's one here, just like a little plastic circle, and you can set that up so that when you tap it with your phone, it does things. So what I'm doing is using an NFC tag to start a timer and putting it in the cupboard where my weights are, just as a reminder. So I'm kind of playing with that idea, and I'll show you that later as well. The idea was, that's what this one's got the stop symbol on it. This was on the kitchen table. And the idea is when I get there, I see this there and I think, that's right, I should stop work. So you can, I'm going to experiment with kind of placing these around my life and using them to trigger me. It's a bit pointless, but whatever. All right. This is what I said at the beginning, that I've always got a timer running. That's true. I always have a timer running, because some of those timers are really generic, personal untracked time or just offline. From about 6:30 p.m. until about 6 a.m. I'm just offline. So I'm not tracking things in that sense. Like I said last time, don't worry if you're like, oh, he wants me to track my life. It's not like that at all. But the point of having the timers running constantly is that I get used to seeing them on my lock screen. Where's my phone? There's always a timer on my lock screen. And if I see my phone, or if I see one of my devices and there isn't a timer there, that's my trigger to say, hang on a minute, you know, something's wrong with the system. So that's why I find it useful, even when I'm just in personal offline time, to have a timer running that just tells me I'm in personal offline time. So to recap, we've got an Apple shortcut, which I'll show you, which activates both a focus mode and starts a timer. And this is how I switch. I'm always switching with a shortcut. I'm never doing it manually. And yeah, we'll get onto the config of these in a moment. All right, let's get you set up. And the first thing we're going to do is clean up in preparation. And I think this is going to horrify some of you, because people seem to get really attached to an arrangement of icons on a phone screen. But it'll be okay. Try this out and trust me. Because we're going to start fresh. I'm going to set you up with a bunch of new home screens focused around the thing you should be doing in any particular mode. So what we're going to do is just delete all of your home screen pages. They're not living things. Don't worry about it. You can put them back later if you really must. And on your final page, we're going to delete all your icons. By the way, just worth noting, I kind of don't use icons on a home screen to launch things anymore. Maybe because I'm just used to changing so often. I tend to swipe across to the library, or I swipe down and just type letters in the search, and that's how I generally launch things. So you do this by holding down on your screen until it wiggles, and then you tap the dots at the bottom there to show all of your different pages. You might not have that many, in which case great, but if you do, remove them all using this icon in the corner. And note that you can't remove a page that's in use, so you've got to uncheck it first. If you really want to keep your main home screen, that's okay, but this is going to be easier if you get rid of everything else. And look, the point is we're trying to be focused, right? Are all of these old home screens helping you be focused? I don't think so. Finally, add a timery widget to your home screen like in the previous video. By the way, if you just want to pause here and look at this nice clean phone that you've got now, might be a good idea. Okay, back to work. So we are going to set up two focus modes for you. You can do more later if you want. We're going to set you up with work and offline. Now, as before, if you've got any old focus modes, clean them up. I had a bunch. The reason I'm doing this is because I didn't do this the first time around, because I thought these things were precious. So I can't delete my screens and my focus modes. I must need them for something. And I found they just got in the way and they just confused me. So That's why we're cleaning up. To do that, there's a video on screen. Just delete your old focus modes. Note that you can't delete Do Not Disturb. It's a special Apple focus mode that you can't get rid of. So let's set up work and offline. Just a reminder, for being in personal mode, personal is just not being in a focus mode. I did try using a specific personal mode called personal. That didn't work as well for reasons that aren't so interesting. So add them like this. You need to select the work item from the bottom of the list here if you want to call it work, because otherwise your iPhone will tell you that the mode already exists. And for your offline mode, choose the first option, custom, and then call it offline and choose your icons and all that. Also, as you'll see, I turn off all app notifications for both modes. You can turn back on what you want later. So just get rid of all of those. Like I said before, choose consistent colors and backgrounds for these modes, and then we're going to use the same colors in Timery and as your wallpaper, because consistency helps your brain. I think the emoji background are really great for this because they're simple and you can just pick a color. My offline mode looks like something you really don't want to use, frankly. That's the idea. I want to see it and think, oh, nope, that's right. Don't want to use that. And my work mode uses a couple of symbols that we kind of use when talking about Johnny.Decimal and has that sort of orange hue. So to set up a new home screen, you hold down your lock screen, you swipe over, you hit the plus, you pick your emoji symbol from the top, and then choose the emoji that you want on the screen. Once you've done that, tap focus here and pick the focus mode that goes with this screen. That's it. Honestly, don't put pictures of your kids or chicken on these screens. You're meant to be at work. They're not meant to be fun, right? Make them functional. Okay, I got two new focus modes and two new home screens to go with them. I can activate the focus modes manually by using Control Center, but we're not going to do that because that doesn't integrate the timers as well. So we need to create shortcuts to do that. I'm not going to do that on this video because we're probably long enough here. We'll do that on the next video. But just to show you how this works, on a Mac, I'm using the menu bar to start a work mode. And then this one has a decision, so it pops up the dialogue and we choose. And then it's the same but simpler for switching to offline and personal untracked time because they are fixed timers and there's nothing to select. And of course, these changes are cascaded to all of the devices. So next time we'll show you how to configure your shortcuts. I'll hopefully be able to just give you downloadable shortcuts because that's a bit fiddly, but I'll give you tons of screenshots. That'll do for now. I'll see you next time.